Sid, I know that when we came to the hideaway, we chose to let go of our past in order that we might focus on our future.
We did.
Nonetheless, I was wondering if... Well, I know you are from Rosaria, and I'm in need of someone with intimate knowledge of those lands. Apparently, the duchy is home to all manner of curative herbs found nowhere else in the realm. Among them is a flower called a Morganbeard that increases the potency of lesser medicines.
I can't say that I've had much practice healing. My youth was spent in the Bailey.
A shame. You see, the hideaway relies heavily upon medicines procured from afar. And when those shipments are late, well, it's our sick who suffer. If we could find this flower and learn to grow it here, we might save many lives. However, as you are well aware, Imperial occupation has rendered the roads unsafe for those like me, untrained in the military arts. Now, I'm not asking the busiest man in the hideaway to drop everything and make the journey for me, but if you happen to be in the duchy on other business...
Tell me of these Morganbeards, then.
But of course... If my old tomes are to be believed, the flowers are bright yellow and as large as goblins' eyes. Oh, and they grow in the marshes of Sorrowise. If I am to propagate them here in the backyard, I will require several samples, preferably of blooms which have already gone to seed. And before I forget, I do seem to recall learning in the course of my research that their odor has the tendency to attract unsavory creatures. Nothing you cannot handle, though, I'm sure.
Let us know if you find any rotten planks. I'll see about replacing them.
Sid, I hear you're planning to visit another Mother Crystal. How, did I hear you ask? Some habits die hard, I suppose. But you needn't worry. We're all on the same side now.
Thank you. you do it. Working under that surly bastard.
It's easy.
How are you doing? Here you go.
Seen enough?
The patron, does that mean...
Oh, no, that's still me. It's just Karen has a toll. I still... Your benefactors are a generous lot. Best of luck out there, Sid.
What's the matter, Nectar? The hunt board? It's where the... Just because... Right, the people of the last...
Here for another of my lectures? Then I bid you good day.
Our man in Dalimil mentioned that Kutka's guard haven't been seen yet.
The calm before the storm, perhaps.
Anything catch your eye? Take care out there, eh?
Thank you for sticking with us.
Those of us who are still here have to look after each other.
It'll take ages to tidy all this stuff up.
Sid.
Good girl.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Near the abbey are certainly damp. Let's see if they're damp enough for Morganbeards. The size of a goblin's eye. Not this goblin. He certainly wasn't wrong about them being attracted to the flowers, though. Good.
Yeah!
Bright yellow. These are our Morgan beards, all right. Well, I've gone to this much trouble. There's something familiar about this scent. It reminds me of home. Hopefully this will be enough. I've had my fill of goblins.
Dalimor mentioned the cook has got it.
It's about time I learned.
Let us know if you find any water.
It is rare that we see you so often in the backyard.
I found your flowers.
Yes, yes. Did you have...
Finding them was the easy part, but I don't remember these flowers specifically, but if the petals are meant to improve the effectiveness of medicines, it's possible that the Corps Physicus grew them for the tinctures and treatments they made my brother.
If the Ducal healers were convinced of their properties... Oh, allow me to use some of the flowers you brought me to make something that might... I need only... And here we are. A phial of pure Morganbeard extract. A single drop added to any one of your restoratives will increase its potency. At least I hope it will.
Clive! Oh, am I glad to see you?
Is something wrong?
It's Blackthorn. He ain't himself, and if I'm honest, he ain't been for a while. But normally it only takes a couple of drinks to perk him back. Something's getting him down. It's like he's lost his spark. But I'm thinking he might if we both bent his ear, because he respects that.
Fine. But if he doesn't...
All right, now, he'll only smell a rat if we both turn up at once. So, I'll go first, and you wait a bit, then head over... One day, I want to sail all the way to the shore.
You'll have to remove your mark first.
First August, and now you. What do you pair up to? What's it got to do with me?
August was worried that something had been weighing on your mind. I thought you might want to talk about it.
Did you now? I told you not to stick your nose in my business. What'd you go and do?
Clive just wants to help, innit? What's so bad about that? Talk to him. You never know, you might feel better for getting it all out in the open. Please, mate. I'm worried about you.
Phil shut you up. It's nothing really. Stupid. Not the sort of thing you'd bother people about.
Why don't you tell us all the same?
Karen and I have an arrangement. I keep an eye on Goots, and she shows me what the competition's up to. Interesting arms and armor, things like that. Anyway, the other day, she shows me a cuirass she's come by. Masterpiece of level work. Light, supple, and tougher than it had any right to be. Made my stuff look like every clumsy shit. I should have brought the bastard thing there and then just to study it, but I was too proud. And now every time I reach for my hammer, I'm reminded that I'm not the craftsman I thought I was. There. You happy? You got what you came for? Now piss off.
All right. We're going. I always thought of old Blackthorn as a bit of a force of nature. Like a storm cloud full of ale. Didn't think anything could rattle him. Least of all a stupid piece of leather.
Blackthorn's always taken pride in his craft. Questioning it means questioning himself. Something tells me this is only going to get worse. If he has doubts, it will affect his work, which will only add to his problems. We need to nip this in the bud.
I couldn't agree more.
He said he should have bought that cuirass. Perhaps we should track it down for him. Assuming you're happy to help, that is.
Too bloody right I am.
Glad to hear it. First things first, then. We need to speak to Karen. Karen, Blackthorn mentioned that you'd recently come by a leather cuirass.
And he ain't been himself since he saw it. So we thought we'd buy it for him.
Sorry, sold it already. Didn't think Blackthorn cared for it the way he turned his nose up. But it were nicely put together, that's for certain. Even if the bloke who made it is a bit of an odd one. Happened across him on my travels. Makes all his stuff to order, but the fella who commissioned it refused to pay. He didn't like the colour of summer, so I took it off his hands for a fair price.
You don't know where we might find him, do you?
Like I said, he's a bit of an odd one. Doesn't even have a workshop. He doesn't trust hunters neither, which means he spends as much time out tracking beasties as he does working their hides.
I see.
He did tell me something, though. Apparently, his next commission's for a set of Griffinhide greaves.
Here, there's a griffin on the hunt board. The curse breakers were placing bets on who'd bag it. Now, where the bleeding hell was it sighted? Somewhere in Sambrec, maybe. Cairn Northern, that was it.
Thank you, Karen. We'd be lost without you.
At least you admit it.
So, it sounds like going after that griffin might be the best chance we have of finding our roaming leather worker.
I'll leave the hunting to you. While you get on with that, I'll ask around the markets. See if I can't sniff out who he is and where he's hiding.
Good idea. Hopefully one of us will be able to track him down.
Good day to you, Sid.
The crystals.
You're quite talented with that rod of yours.
It is, the Black Shields took a hiding.
No use calling Ambrosia now. You deserve a rest.
Come on.
Fly, Ambrosia.
You deserve a rest.
Man and Dalimil mentioned that Kutka's guard hadn't been.
Good day to you, Sid.
Fly, Ambrosia.
griffins don't exactly make for easy prey. Let's hope our craftsman hasn't bitten off more than he can chew.
Thank you.
Something there, boy. Could that be our man? Are you all right?
Yeah. Dare say I'll survive. That griffin caught me before I could get an arrow off. Must have lost sight of me in the grass, though. I'd be dead if it hadn't.
More likely than not.
The name's Camille. I'm a lowly leather worker, if you couldn't tell by the smell of me.
Not so lowly from what I hear. Do you remember selling to a merchant by the name of Karen?
She's not an easy woman to forget. Bought a cuirass from me after I lost my buyer. Quite taken with my work, as far as I recall. Didn't stop her bartering me down to a pittance, though. She sent you for a refund?
It's not her who sent me.
Well, consider me flattered.
You should be. He's a master of his art, and not an easy man to impress.
Blacksmiths are proud folk. It's a rare thing indeed for one to praise a glorified tanner. And I don't imagine an impressive swordsman like yourself would be getting your steel from any but the best. I'd dearly love to help a fellow craftsman, but... Well, actually, I suppose...
What is it?
Treated leather. Same stuff I used to make that cuirass. If your man's as skilled as he sounds, he...
You sure?
Well, and thanks to you, I'll be...
In that case?
I'd be much obliged. Right. I've got some greaves to make. You send your blacksmith my regards.
Will do. Hopefully this will sweeten Blackthorn's...
With a bit of luck. How'd it go, Clive? Did you find him, or does the hunt continue?
I found him. And he asked me to give you this, along with his regards.
You're joking.
He said he wouldn't teach you how to work it, but that if you were as skilled as you sounded, you'd have no trouble understanding how it was done.
So that's his secret. Crafty bastard. He's layered and cross-grained it. Good few times, too. No wonder it's tough. And that's no ordinary oil he's used to get that finish. Oh, this is fine work. Even finer than I thought.
Yeah? I'll take your word for it. Just looks like leather to me. Still, I'm glad you're happy. Here, Clive, you didn't happen to catch the fella's name, did you?
Camille, I believe.
I thought as much. There ain't many leather workers in the realm daft enough to do their own hunting, see? And his name kept cropping up when I was asking around. Turns out he's from Tabor. And again, most leather workers are. But our friend Camille guards a long-held family secret, the details of which are the subject of some debate in the leather-working community.
Then we better keep...
Listen, sorry for putting the both of you to all that trouble. Should have kept my moaning to myself. Still, I'm glad you found him.
That was the idea. Clive's idea, anyway.
It's good to have you back, Black.
Just don't expect me to go turning out work like this. There's a reason he does his own hunting. He knows exactly what hides to look for. And that's how he gets them to layer up so nicely. And don't get me started on how much oiling this leather would need. But I reckon I can make something about as good. Something a Cursebreaker will have no trouble caring for. Anyway, enough narrowing. I've got...
Looks like we won't be needing a new blacksmith.
As if there was a better one out there. I wouldn't have been the same anyway. No one spins a yarn like old Blackthorn in... Right, now that's... Thanks.
What do you need? What do you want?
Is it true what I'm hearing, Sid? You cracked another crystal?
Well, don't just stand there gawping. Come again. I'm not much bothered either way.
Back, are you? Not saying Fornian, do you? Anything else?